We have such a good show for you tonight. We've been working very hard for a while to put it all together. This is a total grassroots event. It took everybody that was involved doing a little bit of here and there, bringing drums, moving stuff, getting speakers fixed, all kinds of stuff, making t-shirts. If you'd like one, they're for sale over there at the table. We're going to move this. So my name is Andrew Elbert, and I am a drummer, a djembe player in Chicago, and I teach a drum class on Sunday nights, and a number of my students started getting that little itch, like they wanted to perform, and at the same time, one of my very own teachers from Guinea, West Africa, Bolokada Conde, the feature performer of tonight. So we put together a really good show for you tonight. My drum class is going to play some beginning music, and then we're going to have the Ayodele community class that meets on Monday nights on the south side of Sherman Park. They're going to do a piece, and then my drum class is going to come back and do some more advanced music, and then you're going to see some more Ayodele dance class, and then a drum ensemble that I direct called the Low End Theory is going to play some music, and then we're going to take a little break, and we're going to come back and see Bolokada and friends. It's going to be a great night. It's going to be a lot of drumming. There's earplugs for only $1 if you need them. It can get loud. And there's water if you need it. A little bit of housekeeping things. The bathrooms are through this way. Over to the left, there's male and female bathrooms. There's water. And there's good times. You guys ready to hear some drums? And while they do that, I wanted to talk about the name of the show a little bit. I almost forgot. It's called Djiraworo. And Djiraworo is the name of an album that Bolokada put together. And he was putting that album together at a time when me and a couple other people that I'm going to introduce tonight were studying really closely with him. So we learned a lot of the music on that album. And it turns out that I actually teach a lot of the music in my drum class from that album. So I said, hey, why don't we play Bolo's whole album tonight? So what's going to happen is the drum class is going to play four tunes from that album, and then Bolokada and friends are going to play the rest of it. So you're going to get to hear music from that album. There's other albums that he's got for sale. There's a lot of cool stuff for sale. Check it out. Justin, my buddy, brought some jewelry. There's a sweet djembe, so in intermission, whenever, you can check it out. Anyway, Djiraworo, as Bolo explained it to me, is a time during a particular initiation time of the year. And it has to do with the respect that a visitor shows a household when they go and visit a household. They want to show respect to the people that live there, their visitors. And what they do is they bring a kola nut for the people that live at the house. And there's a rhythm that is on that CD called Soli Djiraworo, and Djiraworo goes along with the whole Soli festivals and festivities that take place over a given amount of time. If you want to know anything more than that, you have to ask Bolo. Anyway, to celebrate that a little bit, there's some people in here that I do want to show some respect to throughout the night. And I'm going to start with a guy that when I moved to Chicago 10 years ago, he plugged me into the djembe scene like a light socket. And so I brought some kola nuts with me, and I wanted to give some people some kola nuts. So this first guy, his name's Taylor, and I think he's somewhere over there.
Yo, brother.
Yeah. Taylor, when I moved to Chicago, he appreciated me. He appreciated my sound of the drum, and he appreciated my dedication to the djembe. Like I said, he showed me all the good dance classes. He started hooking me up with teaching jobs and all kinds of good stuff. So Taylor, I have a kola nut not going to throw it because it's dark. I can't see. Okay. Can you come get it? Because I'm on a line right here. So that being said, Yost, why don't you come up and get yours too? Because Yost is another one of the guys that I Yost works at Chicago Parks, and now he's the head of a park over at Mozart. And he hosted his teaching in the Risco de Mato when I first moved to Chicago, all the way on Warren Park. I remember I rode my bike from Wicker Park to Devon with my djembe on. So if you know Chicago, that's a lot. Anyway. So those are the two people I wanted to shout out right away. I don't want to keep you guys waiting anymore for these awesome drummers. Awesome. Their first piece is called Balakulanyan Sankaran.
Thank you. for the next piece, you see in drum class, you learn how to play all the different instruments, the djembe, the dunimba, the samba, the kintu. So while they're switching to change, I got another person that I want to talk about, and then a surprise that I didn't tell my drum class about. So when you travel to West Africa, you have to get something called a yellow fever card, so you don't get sick. And when you play djembe, sometimes you get this thing, this infection that people like to call djembe fever. And it's when you can't get enough, and every day you want to play more djembe, and you wake up thinking about djembe, and you fall asleep thinking about djembe. So there's a couple students that are new to me. They've been taking class for just a couple months now, but I'm pretty sure they have djembe fever. In fact, I know they do. So I have these yellow djembe fever cards. And this is to certify that Mateusz Spak and Thomas Cullerton have a confirmed diagnosis of djembe fever, and they are highly contagious. You should use caution around this person if you're allergic to drums, good times, don't enjoy passion for music, or you have yellow fever. Otherwise, you risk rhythmic infection.
So, Mateusz.
Okay, so this next piece is called Dua. It's one of the later tracks on Bolo's album. And we had a special guest come in and teach class to help us with this piece. This is one of my very, very best friends. He's my studio mate. He's my roommate. We hang out all the time together. We play hella drums. And he came in and taught a class to teach these guys a solo sequence. So this guy's name is Jason Wolf, otherwise known as Wolfie. Wolfie is one of my big brothers in Chicago, big djembe brothers, and has shared with me everything he knows, and I've learned a lot from him the 10 years I've been in Chicago. So Wolfie, I have a cold enough for you, man. All right, without further ado, next piece, drum class, Dua. Thank you. So now what we're going to do, we're going to switch up. Drum class is going to move some of these drums. And we're going to get a piece from Ayodele dance class called Gumbe. Okay, so we just got a note in the house that we need to consolidate some seats. So if you have an empty seat next to you, and you can scoot over a little bit or raise your hand, and maybe we can do a general move this way, or raise your hand if there's an empty seat next to you. And anybody that wants a seat by the door, come on in. This is a good time to find one. There's more seats over here. Or if you want to hang out too, maybe that was your deal, and that's also fine. So, Ayodele. Oh, yeah. John, can you bring the piece out? They're going to do a piece called Gumbe. Ayodele dance class. Names are 7 o'clock at 6:30 on Monday night and Thursday night. And it's taught a lot of times by Tasha Ralston and Lionel Dietrich, two of my favorite dancers in Chicago. They are not able to be here tonight. There's a conference in Atlanta that a lot of those ladies are at, but they're here in spirit, I know. And that's all I'm going to say. Enjoy.
Those ladies and gentlemen take dance class at Sherman Park on Mondays and Thursdays at 6:30. And then there's an awesome dance class on the north side at Hamlin Park on Sundays at 3 o'clock. And if you notice, I played for a lot of those. And those other folks that were playing, that was John Chapman on the djembe and Nicole on the other djembe. You're going to see them very soon later. But first, we have another piece by the drum class. We're almost ready. This next piece, it's one of my favorites. It's called Moribayasa Sanka. Thank you. everybody can do it, and that's true. But that doesn't mean it's easy. And I think everybody can do it, but I know it's not for everybody. And some people come and they hit the drum, a hard piece of goatskin or cowskin with their hand, and they're like, what are you talking about? There's no way I want to sit here and hit my hands against this hard thing forever. But that's what we love to do. We love it. And there's a certain personality that takes to it, and I love all those people. And it's still hard, though. And so there's this courage that you need to be able to keep going all the time. And there's a couple of my newer students who they started coming, and from the first week they started coming every single week after that, with like one or two misses in a whole year. And that's pretty amazing. I'm really impressed by that. And so I just wanted to recognize it a little bit. So I have what I'm calling the Determination Award for a couple people. And one of these guys, his name is Carlos. And his first djembe class ever was with Bolokada Conde 1 year ago when we were hosting him at our studio. And so now he's been playing djembe for a year. And like I said, that whole time, ever since he took class with Bolokada, he started coming to my class. And he's missed like two or three that whole time. So Carlos, I have this award. A certificate of recognition for manifesting fantastic determination with good spirit and constant attendance.
Nice.
Thank you, sir. And I have one more. Similar. These guys are pals. They started kind of the same time. Nahi Kodastani. I want to recognize you. The manifesting fantastic determination with good spirit and constant attendance. Awesome. So I have another colonnet to give out as well. So take a look at all these drums up here. Like 90% of them were put together by the same dude. And this is another one of my big brothers in the community, teaches me a lot on and off the drum. And he's got awesome jewelry for sale over there. He's a really excellent craftsman. I get all of my drums skinned by him. He loves anybody that tries really hard at djembe. And if you try really hard, I'm gonna tell a secret about him. So sorry, but if you try really hard and make him happy when you play djembe, he likes to give you things. So I'm sorry that I let a secret out, but it's kind of the truth. But you have to try hard. I mean, it's not like for anything. You can't go and play a little solo and be like, what? No, you gotta like try hard, okay? So anyway, Justin, man, I got a colon up for you. I don't know where you went. I'm gonna try. But he puts together all these drums and helps out all the time. And if you have a drum that you need repaired, you gotta call him. And if you need to buy a drum, you gotta talk to him. And if you need a necklace or earrings, you gotta talk to him. Thanks, buddy. Okay, that's enough for me. So this is the title track of the album. It's called Soli Djiraworo, and I'm really proud of the djembe students here because these phrases that we put together in the intro and the djembe special are not easy, and they've been working hard at them, and they're awesome. So take it away, guys.
Ayodele dancers, you are on cue. So we need 5 minutes to set the stage.
Good evening, everybody. Let's hear it for Andrew Elbert for organizing our show tonight. The mastermind behind this event. Somebody should give that guy a certificate of determination. Anyway, he asked me to say a couple of words about our featured guest this morning while we wait, or this evening. While we're waiting for the Love and Theory to get ready. So, as you have heard by now, our special guest this evening is named Bolokada Conde. Everybody say Bolokada. Bolokada's from Guinea. A lot of them, well, actually, all the music you're hearing this evening is from Guinea, because it's a Djiraworo themed evening. And many of us have had the good fortune of studying with Bolokada, and that's how the show came about. He has connections to so many of us in this room. And I've been lucky enough to travel to Guinea with him, as has my good friend Justin here, who you heard Andrew introducing earlier. And we traveled to a village. Everybody say Morowaya. Morowaya is the name of a small village in Guinea where Bol was born. Bolokada, are you in here? Oh, okay. Hi. of people called Malinke. In Malinke, we want to tell somebody welcome. We say Inisene. Everybody say Inisene.
Inisene.
Everybody say Inike.
Inike.
So that's how you say hello. You welcome somebody in Malinke. So that's a little bit about the background of Bolokada that we're going to be seeing later tonight after the Lowen Theory. He teaches classes all over the United States. Lived in California for a while, is living in South Carolina now. And we have been hosting him in Chicago every summer for many years now. And so we're really happy to see so many new faces. And like Andrew mentioned before, if you think this looks fun, is it fun?
Yeah, baby.
It's fun. Okay, excellent. So it's confirmed. You should check out some of the classes he mentioned. So hopefully the Lowen Theory is just about ready. That's just a little bit of background for our featured guest. So we're going to have the Lowen Theory and then a short intermission, and we'll be back with some more music.
Thank you.
Get some water, call your friends.